I got the pretty, pretty lady with no like, no stress. She got her own, but she needs some love.
Today I'm joined by a award-winning, hilarious, criminally under-pampered comedian. It's Dane Baptiste. How you feeling, brother?
I'm feeling good. I'm feeling valued today. I feel like people care about me.
So let's start with toxic black masculinity. Yeah? Firstly, explain what that is.
It's a build-up on the whole theme of toxic masculinity, where I feel a lot of men in particular feel this pressure to conduct himself in a certain way just due to external pressures. And I think that can, in many, a lot of time, could be a additional pressure, particularly for young black men, especially because a lot of the archetypes they see in the media seem to be very skewed or very binary.
Today, you can see we both got our robes on. We've got our feet in some rose water with soap, right? Is it soap?
Yeah. Yeah, a nice bit of rose petals and that. I'm feeling like Prince Hakeem in Coming to America, basically.
I'm getting those vibes.
It's getting those vibes, and it's a good feeling. And I just think, you know, I think a lot of the time we come from a community where there's encouraged that the best kind of love and the only kind of love is tough love.
Yeah.
But I think being able to take care of yourself and, you know, take care of yourself both inside and out is very important. So, I'm looking forward to this.
It is interesting to see what's happening with comedy. And what's even more interesting is seeing what you've done with your show, Famous, on BBC Three. One thing that really stood out for me, though, was the NASBLAQ, which is a stock market index for black talent, black celebrities.
For now, let's see where I am. Probably around your top 50, top 60, you know, mid-table. It's a minor, though. I still feel blessed to be a part of this whole thing. Probably gonna stop anytime now. Stopping real soon. 674th, me, between Skepta's barber and Howard from the Halifax advert. Am I that much of a dickhead? Does my life even matter?
I think a lot of the time within this data age, we tend to scrutinize people's pasts and always reference to things they've done or said before. And normally the connotations are very negative. So the idea, the NASBLAQ, was to take positive contributions to culture and to art and to have that as a reference point that people always go to. That's me just putting it all together, I guess, kind of like a scrapbook of black excellence, really.
I just want to say to the ladies in the room that it's not easy having a penis. No, I know we make it look like a lot of fun, but with great power comes great responsibility.
I know you have your international tour coming up, the Chocolate Chips. Mm-hmm. Tell me a little bit more about what we can expect from that tour.
Well, the Chocolate Chip kind of worked out really well for me because the idea was that I wanted to write a show which was unapologetic and, you know, just unabashed about the complex of black anger.
Yeah.
And to, always be acting globally but thinking locally. All right, Aaron, take a look at this. This is what I'm talking about.
Oh, wow.
There you go.
Yeah.
Size 11, prime cut, top shelf. There you can go, as you can see. Nice curl there. As you can see, good. The toes go in the declining order, so you've got a nice little foot bottom crescendo there. If started from the bottom, now we're here, was an organ, it'd be these feet.
Dane, I want to say thank you so much for joining me. It's an absolute honor and a pleasure. Thank you, Dane Baptiste.